All right, remember where we're at. Let's get our bearings for a moment. We're talking about the work of God's salvation in us that changes us. There's the work of God's salvation for us. That's the work of Jesus Christ on the cross. But then there's a work that he's doing in us by his Spirit. What's the very first work of the Holy Spirit in us that's changing us?
That regeneration.
Regeneration, right. That's what we looked at in lesson 19. What's regeneration? What's regeneration, Kara?
Making the dead sinner alive by putting the life of Christ in.
Good. Making the dead sinner alive. So we can remember, regenerate, it's to make alive what was dead. And we, of course, are dead in our sin. That truth that teaches us we're dead in our sin is what? That truth, Dory?
Full
depravity. Alright? And so that's exactly why we need regeneration. It's because of total depravity, what we are in Adam. So regeneration is that work of the Holy Spirit changing us. Is our regeneration mediate or immediate? What's the difference? Remember? Allison?
Immediate is when God uses the means of the preaching of it, and then immediate is when he does it without the preaching.
Okay, and what did we say about it? Is it
immediate.
Immediate, without the means. So although preaching comes, and it comes shortly after regeneration, yet the point is that to hear the preaching, and that's what we talk about tonight, calling, to hear the preaching, one must first be made alive, and only then can they hear that preaching. Last time we also talked about conversion. What's conversion? Adam, you know what conversion is?
Mortification of the old man, the quickening of the new man.
Yeah, good. What's mortification of the old man, Adam?
Destruction.
Yeah, putting it to death, strangling it, and the quickening of the new man. That's another way to describe this, putting on the new man. And so that's a life of conversion, constant turning. We sin, and then how we respond to that sin is conversion. We repent. Godly sorrow for sin, turning from it. So we hate and flee from that sin, and then we turn to God. We're striving for obedience before him. So when we're regenerated, there's going to be this life of conversion. And that's part of it. So we looked at regeneration then in a narrower and broader sense. Now tonight, that brings us to calling. Oh, the idea here is that once the dead sinner is made alive, the dead sinner made alive has to come to be active in faith. Or another way to put it is that the dead sinner who's made alive has to come to see and know his salvation or her salvation. And there has to be a change that's worked in them that takes place in their life. And that happens through this saving call that we look at tonight. So a couple things by way of introduction. The saving call is the second step in the order of salvation. We said first is regeneration. The saving call is second. After that is faith, then there's justification and sanctification and glorification. So remember that order that you learned as part of your memory work for lesson 19. Saving faith is the second step in that order of salvation. And that comes after regeneration. You have to be made alive first. And then this takes place. And that's the next point. We cannot be called unless first we are regenerated. All right, with that as our just very brief introduction, let's jump right into this saving call and what it is. So let me begin by giving you a definition. A little longer than you had in the book. It's the work of God through the Spirit by means of the preaching, calling the elect sinner out of darkness and into his marvelous light. Take a look at 1 Peter 2, verse 9. You've written that down. The wording of that definition is very close to what we read in 1 Peter 2, verse 9. 1 Peter 2, verse 9 is the proof text of this. Presley, would you read that for us, please?
For we are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that you should show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light.
Okay, so the wording at the end tells you saving call, who's called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. But notice the beginning of the verse. You can't forget that. It's speaking to the church. And Peter says to the church, this is what you are. This is who you are. He's the word of God speaking to you tonight and saying, this is who and what you are. You are a chosen generation. So a generation of people chosen by God. That's election. You're a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, kingly priests, a royal priesthood, and holy nation, a people. Holy means set apart. You've been set apart by God because he's chosen you and redeemed you. And you're a peculiar people. You're a people who stands out in the world. If you're living like you should, you're going to be standing out in the world. And you do because you're children of the living God, living among people who are children of Satan and children of darkness. And now he says here to that church that ye should, this is why you are this, the purpose is that ye should show forth the praises of him. You're to praise him in everything you do because he's the one who has called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Now we see something about this calling out of darkness into light. Darkness is what? It's not just that you live only in the nighttime, right? What is darkness referring to? What's it referring to, Allison?
Sin.
Okay? So you've been called out of sin, out of the darkness of sin. What's light refer to? Levi, any ideas what light refers to?
Righteousness.
Okay, righteousness. What else? Jury?
Life.
Life? Who is the light, Jury?
God.
So the idea is the presence of God. The presence of God. So you've been called out of darkness to have fellowship with God and to live in the light of the Word of God, in the light of Jesus Christ. So that calling is a work of God calling you and me to repentance, calling you and me to believe in Jesus Christ. It's the call of the gospel. And that's what we're talking about tonight. That's what the saving call is. So as those who are regenerated, we hear that call.